some hand wash on there. Hands are good clean. Welcome to your assessment. So I believe you have a colour defect and we should explore this a little bit more. So let's get straight into it. We're going to start with an Ishihara test. And on each page there's a plate. I just want you to tell me what number you see on each page. Okay. And what can you see there? Let's go to another part, the Yara. So there should be two numbers there. Now which number stands out the most? And which number stands out more on this plate? Same again. Which number stands out more on there? The same there. This. Okay, that concludes the Ishihara test. Now I have a coloured grid here. I'm going to point to some squares. Just tell me what colour you see. We're going to move on to the City University colour vision test. Let's just find the right page for you. Okay. Which circle stands out more than the others out of these three? Which is a slightly different shade of colour to the other two. Any on there? And here? And what about there? Okay. Page two. Does one of these stand out more than the others in terms of the shade? Yeah. any standing out. Okay. Looking at this circle in the centre. Which circle around it closely matches the colour of the central spot. And the next page, which circle closely matches the spot in the centre in terms of colour? This one? Here, maybe this one, but you're not too sure. Maybe this one. Okay. And on there, which one is matching the sector circle? Maybe the top one, you feel? This one's just a little bit smaller, same idea. Good. You want to see it again, maybe the bottom. Okay, I'm gonna go for the bottom. And we have two more to go. It's a little bit tricky. Maybe the top. Okay. And the final page. Which circle closely matches the centre in terms of colour? Which is the most similar shade? Okay. Well, there certainly does appear to be a colour vision defect. You were right. Okay, let's have a look at the Amsler grid, just to make sure there's no distortion in the central vision area. So looking at the grid, they're looking at the spot in the centre. As you're looking at the spot, can you see all four corners of the grid? As you're looking at the spot, are any of the lines distorted, bendy or wavy? Good. And do you have any holes, missing bits on the grid as you continue to look at the spot? Okay. This one will just help with the fixation of the spot. Does everything look normal, straight, as you're looking at the spot? All the vertical and horizontal lines, that is. Excellent. Same again, slightly different shade of grid. Any problems there? Good. And we have a horizontal grid. As you're looking at the spot, any distortion on the horizontal lines? Good. And what else do we have? We have a finer grid in the centre of the main grid. Continue looking at the white spot in the centre. Any distortion on the smaller inner grid? And what about the outer grid? That looks fine. Good. We may have one more for you. That's all of them. Very well done. Okay, what do we have next? We're just going to have a look at some near charts of everyday prints. map here. Is the map looking fairly clear at this distance? Okay. Are you able to determine the motorways and A roads and B roads? Okay. Just about in terms of colour. Make it a little bit closer for you, for better focus. Have a look at this nutritional label. Is everything looking clear for you? Good. You see the smaller prints? Good. And we have an intermediate chart, so we'll hold this a little bit further back. Roughly computer distance, for example. Are all the figures looking clear for you? And a GPS device here. Is that looking clear as well? Can you see the data here fairly clearly? If anybody still uses a PDA in this day and age, nevertheless, is that clear for you? And one more, we just have a train ticket. And a normal person with normal colour vision will see these parts as orange. What colour do you see them as? A murky green colour. Okay. Is the print clear on the ticket? Okay. Very good. Okay. Okay, we're just going to do a near vision Thomas the Tank reading assessment. What colour does Thomas and Gordon appear to be? Yeah. Like a royal blue. Maybe just a little bit lighter. Okay. Is the print clear here? N10? What about N8? Moving down to N6. And N5. Is the print clear? The small N5 print for you. Okay, very good. Okay, and we just have a vision picture card. Just tell me some of the pictures you can see as I point to them. That's looking fairly crisp and clear. Okay. What else do we have? We have a vision chart. So let's check the vision a little bit further back. Just read down on the chart as far as you can for me, starting from the top. Next row. And the bottom row. Good. So at the moment there doesn't appear to be any problems with your vision. I'm just going to do another near chart assessment with some various different objects. As you're looking around, just tell me if you see any blur, double vision, or if you experience any eye strain. And you currently don't wear glasses, is that correct? Just looking anywhere on the grid. Just for any blur. A double eye strain. Excellent. I think we should do an eye health assessment next. So today I'm going to dilate your pupils as you're not driving. We're going to use some tropicamide eye drops. Sting initially when they enter the eye. That goes very quickly. And they will leave you blurred for about 4 hours afterwards. Okay. Just looking up for me and I will instill a drop in the right eye and a drop in the left eye. And I will discard of this. Okay, just give yourself a few seconds just to let the drops wear off. Set up my magnification device. Okay, as the stinging wore off, excellent. So I'm just going to have a little magnified view of the front of the right eye first, just checking for any abnormalities. That's good. Okay. Just looking up. And right and looking down, looking straight. Just close your eye for me. Now open, take a few blinks. Okay, looking straight ahead. Check the left eye, blink, look up. To the right, look to the left, looking down, straight ahead, just close the eye again, open, and take a few blinks. Pupils are definitely starting to dilate nicely there. So I'm going to give you about 5 to 10 minutes for the drops to work completely. I'll see you shortly. Okay, welcome back. I'm going to perform some ophthalmoscopy. The eyes. And beam of light. Just collect aperture and select the right. Okay, looking straight ahead so I can look through the eye. Lens is clear, cornea is grossly clear. Optic nerve, macula. Okay, looking up again, up and left, to the left, up and right, right, down to the floor, down and right. And down and left. Okay, looking into the light for me. Okay, let's have a look at the left eye. Looking straight ahead. Now looking up. Up and right. Directly left and right, straight down to the floor, down and right, and down and left. Okay, just looking into the light for me now. concludes the examination. So apart from your colour defect, which is genetic and will never change, your eyes do appear healthy. So I'm going to put you on a 2-year recall, and I want you to return if there are any problems with your eyes in the meantime. Thank you.